Hey guys, in this video we'll be looking at the Retrofit library. It's an HTTP client for Android and Java. So basically, type safety prevents you from type errors like treating an integer as a string or as a double. Retrofit turns your HTTP API into a Java interface. We can use dynamic URLs, we can use annotations to describe HTTP requests, and so on. Retrofit has 5 built-in methods for HTTP request, like the get, post, put, patch, and delete. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'll be using this JSON placeholder.api. It's a fake online REST API for testing and prototyping. You can go to these links and you can see what type of JSON you are getting. So suppose if we go to jsonplaceholder.ipcode.com/todos, we'll get a JSON array of JSON objects, which are todos. And if we want to go to a specific todo, let's say /todos/1, then we'll get a single JSON object consisting of a user ID, which is an integer, an ID, which is again an integer, a title, which is a string, and a completed boolean. So to implement Retrofit in your workflow, we need to follow these 4 steps. Firstly, we'll add the dependency for Retrofit, JSON and JSON converter. JSON is a Java library which is used to convert Java objects into their JSON representation. Secondly, we'll be making a POJO as required by our application. Thirdly, we'll make an API client class which will return our Retrofit instance. And then we'll create our API interface to call our HTTP endpoint. Then we can use it from anywhere. So adding dependencies is simple. At the time of recording this video, these were the latest dependencies available. You can go to the respective links to find the latest version of the dependency. Second step is to make a Java object. Like in our case, we are making a todo class, which has an integer user ID, an integer ID, a string of title, and a boolean, and the default setters and getters, and a default constructor for the same. Now this is our API client class, where we specify the base URL, and then we have a single method of get client, and where we check if retrofit is null, then we create a new retrofit instance, providing in the base URL, adding in the converter factory, and then returning the instance. Now this is our API interface. So if we look at the first one, that is the call of list to do, that is get todos. Here we have annotated it with get, and in the brackets we have passed in the endpoint, that is the /todos to get all the todos. Annotations on the interface method indicate how the request is handled. URL can be dynamically updated using replacement blocks, as we can see in the second one, which are alphanumeric strings surrounded by curly braces. A corresponding parameter must be annotated with path using the same string. And if we look at the third one, we can see that query parameters can also be added by annotating with query. And if we look at the fourth one, an object can be specified for use in HTTP body with the body notation. This is a cheat sheet which where you can pause and have a look at the different type of endpoints and the different type of request, and how do we pass in the headers also if required by your application. Now from the main activity, we create an instance of an API interface. Then we get the interface using API client dot get client dot create API interface dot class. Then we can use this instance to get our endpoints, that is the get todos. This is one of the example of getting all todos. So we'll be looking more into this when we are into Android Studio. So without wasting any further time, let's jump into Android Studio. So here we have created an empty Android project. So the first step was to add the dependencies for the libraries. So just go to the build.gradle file and add the dependencies, and let's sync it. Now going back to our main activity, or rather let's create a todo Java object. That was our second step. So we create a class to do and a private int of id, that is the id of the to do, and a private int user id, that is who created this to do, and a private string of title and a private boolean, which is whether the task is completed or not. Now we add in our constructor for this class. So we press command N on Mac to create a constructor for this class. And again we press command N to create getters and setters for this class. So these are the default getters and setters for this class. Now our third step was to create an API client class. So let's create that API client. And here firstly we'll specify the base URL. So private static final string base URL, and that base URL we can copy and paste from here because we are using JSON type code. So we'll use this, and then our private static retrofit which is equal to null initially. Now we create a public method, that is the private public static retrofit get client, which will return our retrofit instance. Firstly we'll check if our retrofit is equal to null. If retrofit is equal to null, then we'll create a new instance of that retrofit dot builder dot base URL, that is we provide in the base URL, and that base URL we have specified above. Then we'll add in a converter factory, that is the JSON converter factory dot create, and then we'll build this retrofit instance. And then finally what we are going to do is we are going to return this retrofit to be used in our main activity or wherever you want. So this is our API client class. Now let's again go to main activity, and let's first create our interface method. So we'll create our interface, new Java class. We'll create this class to interface and we'll call it API interface. API interface. Now before doing anything in this interface, let's go to activity main.xml to create four buttons. I'll be forwarding this because you don't want to watch me doing this. So basically here we have created four buttons. That is, the first button is to get all the to-dos. The second one is to get the to-do using a route parameter. The third is to get to-dos using query parameters. And fourth one is to post a to-do. And we have provided an on-click listeners to all these four buttons inside the main activity. First, let's go to jsonplaceholder.ipcode.com. So this is a fake online REST API. If we scroll down and look at the resources, it provides a certain type of resources, that is a post, comments, albums, photos, and blah, blah, blah. So we are going to use the /todos one, which will return 200 todos. So if we go to /todos, we'll be getting this list of todos. It's a JSON array consisting of JSON objects. So if you're using why my JSON is so pretty, I'm using this extension called JSON View, which is available on the Chrome Web Store. You can install it. So here we get a list of todos, that is they are about 200 todos. So if we go to /todos/1, we get a single to do which consists of a user ID, an ID, a title, and a completed boolean. So this is what we have used in our to do class. And if we go to /todos and we use a query parameter, that is to get the to do with an ID of equal to 1, we get this to do. And you can see using query parameters, it provides us a JSON array of JSON objects and not a single JSON object as in the route parameter. We can see the route parameter here. We get a JSON object here, and in this, using the query parameter, we get a JSON array here. So now, if we look at one more example of query parameter, where we are provided in the user ID, which is equal to 1, and a completed equal to true. So we get all the to-dos which has a user ID is equal to 1. So let's refresh this. So here we get all the to-dos which are for user ID is equal to 1 and which are also completed. So now let's go back to Android Studio. So now back in our API interface. So the first one we are going to do is to get all the to-dos. So we annotate this request with @get, and in the brackets we provide in the relative URL, that is the / to-dos, and we make a call. And what we are expecting from here, we are expecting a list of to-dos, and we say create a method called get to-dos like this. Now let's go to in our main activity. Let's create our instance of API interface, and in our onCreate method, let's initialize this API interface. API interface is equal to API client dot get client dot create API interface dot class like this. Now inside the get to-dos, now we have to make a call to this interface method. We say call and list of to-do call is equal to API interface dot get to-dos like this. Now we need to enqueue this call dot enqueue. This is an asynchronous method which you should typically use in your application so that it is not non-blocking. And when the response is successful, we get a response. So what we are going to do, we are going to simply log it in our console. I've just created a tag here, and what I'm going to do, log e plus response dot body, because response dot body consists of our JSON array. And if it is a failure response, then we just log the error here. Now if we run this application and we open our logcat here, so if everything is fine, we'll get a list of to-dos. Let's clear our console. So we have not added a permission for the access to missing internet permission, so let's add our internet permission in manifest file. Users permission internet, so now let's run our application once again and open up our logcat. And now if we click on get to-dos, we'll be getting a list of to-dos, and here are our list of to-dos. We cannot see the to-dos, but we are getting a list of to-dos. These are all JSON objects. So what we can do is we can go to our to-do Java file, Java class, and what we can do, we can add in a toString method here like this. And if we run our application again, now let's close our manifest file, and if we click on get to-dos again, you can see the to-dos which we are getting from our API. So you can see that we are getting a JSON array here. And a first to-do, that is the ID equal to 1, user ID equal to 1, title something something, and completed is equal to false. So we can see here we are getting a list of to-dos. So now let's look into the second method, that is to get a to-do using a route parameter. So in our API interface, so here we need to make a call to get a to-do and get to-do. And we need to get our to-do with an ID. So let's pass in the ID here. and this is our method, and here we have to annotate it with the type of request, that is the get request, and forward slash to do's forward slash, and here we provide in the replacement block for the ID which we pass in here, and for this ID to be used up here we need to annotate it with path. So add path, and in the brackets we provide in the ID. It's the same as you provided in the replacement block. Now go to our main activity, and in this method get to do using route parameter, what we need to do, we need to make a call to get a to do. To do call is equal to API interface dot get to do, and here we are manually passing in the ID of a to do. Let's say we want to get a to do with an ID of 3, and again we need to enqueue this call, to do call dot enqueue new callback, and we simply log it in the console. That is our response. So if you can see that response has some other method also. We are going to use a body because the body contains our to do. You can also find the response code, the response headers, whether the response is successful or not. To get a to do, we use response.body. And for the failure, what we are going to do, we are going to simply log the failure like this, t.getLocalized message. Now let's run this. And let's clear a console. And if we let's clear it once again. And if we click on get to do using route parameter, we can see that we are getting a to do with an ID of 3 which we passed in here. So this is the kind of interface method using the route parameter. Now thirdly, what we'll be looking at, we'll be looking at to get the to-dos using query parameters. So let's come in this method, that is get to-dos using query. Let's close our logcat and let's go to our interface method. We make a call to get a list of to-dos using query parameters, get to-dos using query. And what we need to pass in here, we need to pass in, go to Chrome and see what kind of query parameters we can use. So if we use a query parameter of ID, we'll get a single to do because ID is unique. And let's look at different example of query parameters. So here we have provided in a query parameter of user ID and a completed. So here we are getting a list of to-dos which are for user ID is equal to 1 and which are completed also. There are no to-dos here which are false, that is they are not completed. So let's go to our application here, and here we need to pass in the user ID and a boolean completed like this. And again we have to annotate it with get request because this is a type of get request, and this is the endpoint to-dos. And to use the query parameters, what you can use directly here, or else we can directly annotate it inside the method itself using the add query annotation. Add query, and we need to pass in the user ID here, and again for the completed also we need to annotate it with query, add query and completed like this. So this whole will resolve like this in the URL. So now going back to main activity, we have to again do the same thing, call of list to do, because this is what we are expecting from our call. So list call equal to API interface dot get to do's using query, and first one is the user ID. Let's say user ID is equal to 2, and we want all the tasks, all the to-dos which are not completed. So let's pass in false here. And again, list call dot enqueue new callback. And again, here we just log our response plus response dot body like this. Let's run it again. Open our logcat. Let's clear the console and let's click on get to do's using query parameters. So here we have our response. We can see that all the to do's which we get are for user ID is equal to 2 and they are all not completed. That is, completed is equal to false. You can pause the video and have a look around that all the to do's which we are getting here are for user ID is equal to 2 and they are not completed. Now let's look at how to post something to our API. So again, go to our API interface and create another method called todo, because this is what we are expecting from our API, that when we post a todo, then this is what we are getting back in response. So post todo, and we can, as you know, that we can directly pass in a Java object here as a body, and we have to annotate it with body annotation, body like this, and this is a post request, so we can post a todo like this. And where we want to post it, we want to post it to the end part, that is the forward slash to do's. And now let's get back to our main activity. Again, we have to do the same thing, or rather, firstly, we have to create a new to do. So let's create a new to do. To do, to do is equal to new to do. And because our Java class accepts 4 things, that is the ID, user ID, and a title and completed, but since ID should be automatically generated on the server, so let's create another constructor for this class, command N and constructor. And here we are not going to use the ID, we are just going to use the user ID, the title, and the completed. So let's create this to do constructor, and now let's go here and we can pass in the user ID. Say we want to create a new to do for user ID 3, so we need to pass in here 3, and we can say the title should be get me milk, and this to do should be not completed initially, so let's say it is false. And now what we can do, we can make a call and we expect a to do, and a to do call, or say to do post call is equal to API interface dot post to do. And what we want to post, we want to post this to do. And when we get a response from our API, we can see that the ID is automatically generated for this to do. So to do post call dot nq new callback to do, and log e error again. I like error messages because they are highlighted. So we can log the response dot body again here. And if we run our application again and we open our logcat, and we just click on post to do, we have our to do. And you can see that the ID is automatically generated on the server, and the user ID is 3, and title get me milk completed is equal to false. So this is all about retrofit. You can also pass in headers and all. You can have a look around. So thank you. Bye-bye. If you like the video, do hit the like button. And if you haven't subscribed till now, do subscribe to my channel, and have a good day. Bye-bye.